What is going on, guys? This is the Solve Wall, so you're back with another video, and today I would like to talk about Bethesda's E3 2015 conference. Before I begin, be sure to subscribe to Older Games and like this video. Alright, let's begin. So Bethesda's E3 will take place on June 14th, that is on a Sunday, at 6:30 p.m. Pacific. And one of the first things that I actually predict is that there are obviously going to announce Fallout 4. It is obvious. I mean, like, Bethesda having its own kind of E3, you gotta have something big. And Fallout 4 is probably going to be the center of attention, along with Doom. You know, the 10-second Doom trailer did kind of like tease that they are going to show gameplay for it. They're probably going to announce Fallout 4 on next-gen systems, the PS4 and the Xbox One. And I don't think, you know, probably they are going to set a, not a specific date, but probably for a winter 2016-2017 release date. Because especially that games like Fallout and the Elder Scrolls series are big games, so, you know, it's probably 2 years ahead or anything like that, because it's been a long time since we've got a new Fallout. We've got the latest one, which is Fallout New Vegas, and it was released back in 2010, so that was like 5 years ago. So I would expect to have some kind of, like, you know, not specific, but kind of a target release date that I really wish they would actually make it. And as for Doom, they are going to announce the beta, and they're probably going to have to, because last year they did kind of, you know, if you had pre-ordered Wolfenstein The New Order, you would actually get access to the Doom beta. So I would predict they would actually just kind of announce when the beta is going to happen, if there will be a open beta. Also, I would like to show you this picture of Dishonored 2, in which it was, you know, kind of leaked, I should say, but it wasn't publicly announced, and the target release date was 2016, and, you know, like, you've got the new protagonist, multiplayer mode, new powers, and a new world, actually. I'm pretty sure that Bethesda are going to announce this game, and I'm really worried that, I really wish they would actually just make it a next-gen exclusive kind of game, like, they would just keep the PS3 and the Xbox 360 away, because, you know, it's been a year, and it's better to focus on something new rather than just go back and, you know, hold back the next-gen consoles. And of course, after that, they're probably going to tease Elder Scrolls 6. This is my prediction. I'm not 100% sure. I'm like 60% sure, you know, because Skyrim was released back 4 years ago, and, you know, it's still popular today with the modding community on PC. I'm pretty sure that Bethesda are going to announce a Elder Scrolls series, you know. Elder Scrolls Online isn't a, you know, a big Bethesda game. Sure, you know, it was an Elder Scrolls game, but they're probably going to, like, you know, mention Elder Scrolls Online being released and everything like that, because especially that it's going to, you know, the PS4 and the Xbox One versions of the game are going to release on June 9th, 2 weeks or a week before their conference. So that's my prediction for Bethesda E3. I'll be making for Microsoft and all of the others. Be sure to subscribe to Older Games, comment down below what you think that will happen in Bethesda's E3, you know, what games would you like to see from them, what, you know, stuff that you would like them to announce. If you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like, and I'll see you guys in the next video.